The National Constitution Day, which is also celebrated as National Law Day or the Samvidhan Divas, is celebrated on the 26th of November every year to commemorate the adoption of Constitution of India. The Republic Day is celebrated on 26 January 1950, which was the day when the Constitution of India was formally adopted in practice. The history of our Constitution starts way back before 1947, when we attained independence from the British. When the Quit India movement and the freedom struggle for India began, and the lawyers and different intellectuals in the country, headed by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, started writing the Constitution of India. There is a gap of 2 months between the National Constitution Day and Republic Day. And in these 2 months, the huge Constitution of India was thoroughly read and translated from English to Hindi and different languages. The assembly at that point of time met for around 11 months before the Constitution was actually adopted on the National Constitution Day. The Constitution was formally adopted in the year 1950 after it was passed and accepted by the Constituent Assembly of India. The Constitution, when it was adopted on January 26th, was not received well by many criticized, and the issues of languages, rights, minorities and the entire government structures were debated in the Parliament and around the country. 26 November was celebrated as the Constitution Day in the year 2015, in line with the 125th birth anniversary of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who is the father of the Indian Constitution. This day celebrates B.R. Ambedkar as well as the values of the Constitution upon which India is formed. Ambedkar was a famous politician, jurist and a reformer, and he was a kind of gladiator from the underprivileged section of India population, and hence rightfully is known as the father of Indian Constitution, because he headed the drafting committee of the Constitution on August 29, 1947, a few days after India attained independence. Constitution of India declares a socialist, secular, democratic and sovereign republic that gives the citizens of the country with equality, justice and liberty, and promotes the values of fraternity. The Constitution is the sole backbone of the country that has kept the country together with so many diverse cultures, languages, ethnicities since 70 years. Any institution or citizen not following the values of the Constitution can lead to anarchy in the country. The Indian Constitution is one of the biggest constitution in the world, because the creator of the Constitution took the essence from American, British and Japanese Constitution. It can be said that the Indian Constitution is an amalgamation of the best of the constitutions in the world. The Indian Constitution offers and guarantees few fundamental rights to citizen that the state and the central government should implement it in practice and in spirit. Any harm to the democratic and secular fabric of the nation should be condemned, because harm to the democracy of India is harming the Constitution of India. I would like to conclude by saying that Constitution is the sole and the only book that the institutions in India, such as the Supreme Court, the Assembly and the different states and district level government, should use. There is no alternative for the Constitution of India, and it is the ultimate authority over which the Indian government should run. In a case where the Constitution of India is not followed in spirit and in practice, then that is the line where a government or a country will become a fascist and an authoritarian regime. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.